practice meditation, connecting with the divine. With your eyes open is darshan. Come, let us all now move from meditation to darshan. Slowly, very slowly, please open your eyes.
யோகமே கொண்டிடேழு லோகத்திற்கேட்டா ஈசன் முக்தி நேரி அருளவேனாய் ஊரகிற்கு வந்தம்மை ஆட்டுள்ள தேவர்களை காத்திட வைத்தான் தாயாய் பேரருள் கூறிய உடல் ரோமம் சிரித்திட நித்யனாய் வந்து அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தான் புவி எண்ணாத யோகமே கொண்டிட நித்யன் ஈரேழு லோகத்திற்கேட்டா ஈசன் முக்தி நேரி அருளவே நித்யனாய் மலையில் பிறந்தார் திருவண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார் இத்தை கிளப்பி விட்டேனில் பர தத்துவம் கற்பித்த பாரமஞானியாய் ஞான கண் கொடுத்த தமக்கே தூவம் காட்டிய மாய வித்தை செய்யும் நித்யன் இத்தை கிளப்பி விட்டேனில் பர தத்துவம் கற்பித்த பாரமஞ்ச ஞானக்கண் கொடுத்ததமக்கே ரூபம் காட்டிய மாய வித்தை செய்யும் நித்யன் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தான் புவி எண்ணாத யோகமே கொண்டிட நித்யன் ஈரேழு லோகத்திற்கிட்டா ஈசன் முக்தி நேரி அருளவே நித்யனாய் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தான் நித்யன் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தான் நித்யனை ஆழ்ந்து சிந்திக்க ஐயனின் ரூபம் விளங்கும் தாண்டும் சிவசக்தியாக ஐம்பொறிகளுக்கும் புலனாகின்ற நித்யன் மெய்பொருளான நித்யனை ஆழ்ந்து சிந்திக்க ஐயனின் ரூபம் விளங்கும் தாண்டும் சிவசக்தியாக ஐம்பொறிகளுக்கும் புலனாகின்ற நித்யன் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தான் புவி எண்ணாத யோகமே கொண்டிட நித்யன் ஈரேழு லோகத்திற்கிட்டார் ஈசன் முக்தி நெறியாருளவே நித்யனாய் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார் திருவண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார் உள்ளும் பூரமும் இருந்து உயிர் பக்குவமாக்கிடும் பரமனாம் நித்யன் ஞானப்பாடி தங்கள் ஏழும் கொண்ட ஞானமும் ஆகியே ஆண்டிடும் நித்யன் உள்ளும் பூரமும் இருந்து உயிர் பக்குவமாக்கிடும் பரமனாம் நித்யன் ஞானப்பாடி தங்கள் ஏழும் கொண்ட ஞானமும் ஆகியே ஆண்டிடும் நித்யன் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார் புவி எண்ணாத யோகமே கொண்டிட நித்யன் ஈரேழு லோகத்திற்கிட்டார் ஈசன் முக்தி நேரி அருளவே நித்யனாய் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார் நித்யன் அண்ணாமலையில் பிறந்தார்
பஞ்சத்தை அது வாழ்வில் பெறும் மேன்மை शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरि पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम् I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the living and practicing Hindus from all over the world. I welcome all the Sarvajna Peetha Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Sarvaparityagis, Shrimahans, Mahans, Kotaris, Tanedar, visitors, viewers, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, Kailasas e-Gurukul students, Kailasas NHU students, Paramashiva Ganas, Paramashivoham season 8 participants, everyone with us, all over the world. Through Kailasa TV, Kailasas NTV, Kailasas HNTV. I welcome all of you. With my love and blessings. Paramashiva's message directly from Kailasa. Chemistry of this pralaya happening right now. Listen. When I use the word chemistry of this pralaya, what is the chemistry happening in the cosmos for this pralaya to start, get initiated, and what is the chemistry it is manifesting in all of us? What is the alchemy process to save ourselves from this pralaya, deluge, pandemic, eco-pandemic, pandemic fatigue, and all the after effects of pandemic? Please understand. Knowing the chemistry of this pralaya, you can protect yourself from this pralaya. Listen, knowing the chemistry of this pralaya, you can protect yourself from pralaya. Yesterday I was explaining the physics of this deluge. Pralaya is delusion. What usually delusion does to your system is the chemistry. Listen, what is the impact of your inner on your inner chemistry of this delusion? How this delusion impacts your inner chemistry? Discontinuous very suicidal arrogance, life negative suicidal arrogance, that is also not continuous, like a extreme mood swings. Extreme mood swings. Understand, delusion's impact, the first impact will be extreme mood swings. The first impact of Bhava Samadhi will be extreme ecstasy. Absolute joy, brain filled with nectar. The first impact of delusion will be extreme mood swings. Feeling disconnected even with the purpose of your existence and life. Understand? That is why I am insisting this till December 14th, bring more and more love, joy, completion, unclutching, understand. Take my words very seriously. Every word I am uttering is really, really, really uttered with extreme sincerity. Understand? Unclutching, completion, not sleeping more than 6 hours, all these are too important for you to keep yourself together at least till December 14th. Extreme violence inside outside, murderous, suicidal will be the normal flow due to this pralaya. People who usually act during the mood swing, keep your knives, everything away from your reach. How we say, keep all this out of children's reach. Keep all this out of your reach. I tell you, if you have the pattern of acting out of extreme mood swings, keep all the knife, poisonous chemicals, everything out of your reach. I mean it. Understand? Every word I am uttering is carefully thought through and completely consciously uttered with the responsibility. But the word, and not only the word I am uttering, even how I sit, how I present myself is very consciously done. Listen. Listen to this. Jata, Kasma, Rudraksha, all these represents my integrity to Charyapada, lifestyle Paramashiva teaches. The Atma Linga I am always wearing, which I do Nitya Puja every day. The Atma Linga I am always wearing and to which I do Nitya Puja represents my integrity to Kriya Pada of Paramashiva's words. Listen, I used to tell everyone, even if you miss food, don't miss puja. Even during my Parivaraja Yatra, sometimes if I was not able to carry the deity with me, see, it's like a, sometimes we will think, okay, we will go to the nearby village, one temple, and come back by evening, but we may not be able to come back and we might have been stuck due to some natural calamity or unable to come back. Even that kind of situations, days, I'll make a linga out of water. If one drop of water, that will be called Jalalinga or a Rudraksha as a linga, and we'll do puja, but we'll never miss puja. This wearing of Atma Linga shows my integrity to Kriya Pada of Paramashiva. Padmasana and sitting straight shows my integrity to Yoga Pada of Paramashiva. The great truths I am downloading and sharing with you all is demonstration of my integrity to Paramashiva's Jnana Pada, Vidya Pada, Jnana Pada. Understand? So everything I utter or do is absolutely in integrity with Paramashiva and his teachings. Now, with that integrity, I am sharing this truth with you. Please listen. Due to this pralaya, deluge, your past violence, karmas, everything will be triggered from the source. It is also good news if you can use this opportunity to complete all the unknown incompletions which will now gush out, which will now be smoked out, which will now ooze out due to this deluge. Understand? When there is a collective deluge, pralaya, even the deepest layers of your patterns, incompletions, all will ooze out. So, if you practice absolute completion, non-violence, non-reaction, no response internally, externally, for all the incompletions, patterns coming out, erupting out, gushing out, oozing out. If you go for unclutching, this pralaya, this pandemic time will give you super conscious breakthrough, enlightenment, powers, and not only you will sail through this pandemic, pralaya, you will give a super conscious breakthrough to others by setting a trend model. I tell you, too many things which you loved, which you thought as part of your everyday life, too many people whom you loved, who are part of your everyday life, will not be there anymore as they used to be. There will be some deaths, there will be some people losing their qualities of what you call as them. Understand? Listen to this truth. If there are two people who hate Nityananda, there are 2 million people who hate what they falsely think as Nityananda. That is what is delusion-based hatred. All these delusion-based hatred will melt down. Same way, the celebrities who are promoted by the brand-building business exercise, many of them are loved for which is not really their quality. Listen, I am hated by many people who falsely think what is Nityananda. Same way, these celebrities whose brand is built by large money and brand building exercises, those celebrities are loved for what they are not. Delusion-based love and delusion-based hatred, both will melt down. Understand? If two people, listen to this very clearly, again, if two people hate Nityananda, 2 million are made to hate Nityananda for what he is not. By the false propaganda, 2 million people hate their false idea of Nityananda. The false idea propelled love, false idea propelled hatred, both will melt down in this deluge. For many people whom I was not part of their life, will suddenly, they will discover me as an important component in their life to keep themselves together. Many celebrities whom you thought as part of your life will suddenly lose their influence over your life. Understand, all this is an amazing opportunity. Chemistry of this pandemic, pralaya, provides an opportunity for you to go through the alchemistry of enlightenment. Many things which you need to be unclutched will be now forcibly unclutched from you. Only thing, you should not become violent, angry, depressed about it. Understand? every day. Just like you breathe, what is available in the form of air, eat what is available in the form of food, you consume the ecosystem which is available in the form of thoughts, emotions, actions and reactions. You cannot stop its influence over you. How much ever you think you are intelligent, you can stop the negative news inside you, reaching to you. No, you can't. Only thing you can do is your inner space can be purified with unclutching, so the negative news doesn't influence you, impact you, collapse you. Only that is possible. Absolutely stopping the negative news is not possible, because especially now, you need to know about what is happening around you to protect you. The rules and regulations what's happening what you need to do for protecting yourself from this pandemic, so many things, so many information need to reach you from the outer world. So you can't completely disconnect yourself. The news has to reach you. Naturally, when you allow the news to reach you, all the other things associated with it reaches you. But your reaction is in your control. It's not in somebody else's control. Fortunately, nobody else is sitting inside and thinking for you. I'll give you few example statements body which does not have craving addictions is billion worth. Body which salivates, which tastes, rejoice fasting is more than billion. I should say multi-billion dollar worth. body which can sit in Padmasana and unclutched. And have high, powerful cognitions inside you. Trillions, trillions, trillions worth. If God gives me the option, hey, body which can sit in Padmasana unclutched, having high consciousness, one side, the other side, $1 trillion, I will absolutely 120% full consciously, clearly will choose straight the body which can sit in Padmasana unclutched and have powerful cognition. Because that can manifest much, 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 much higher things than any $1 trillion. Same way, listen, mind, which has less reactions, is like millionaire's mind. Mind, which is unclutched, is billionaire's mind. It will manifest billions in its life. The mind, which is unclutched, but intensely active, even in the unclutched state, from Paramashanta Swarupa, from the absolute peaceful state, intensely active, that mind is beyond trillions, trillionaire's mind. It is beyond violence, non-violence. It knows to be absolutely established in non-violence and do what is right. Like Krishna himself telling Arjuna, hey, non-violence is the ultimate. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Now kill all these people because they need to be eliminated for the planet Earth Srishti to be alive. Apparently violent, but absolutely non-violent. Apparently violent, absolutely non-violent. That is beyond ordinarily what you understand as violence, non-violence. That is the cosmic level non-violence. Krishna leading the Mahabharata war is absolute cosmic level non-violence. Ahimsa in the scale of universe. Because too much of weapons were piled up. Too many people had the knowledge of too much of weapons. Like too many people know the Brahmastra, science at that time of Mahabharata war. Too many people knows the science of too many astras, weapons. So any one weapon left in the hands of a guy who can do the violent reaction due to his assumptions, who can go crazy, who can just lose his balance, can destroy the whole planet Earth. It was almost like a, when the Prakriti, Srishti will be destroyed, nobody knows. Too many people, Dronacharya, Ashwatthama, too many people know the science of Brahmastra. Persons like Ashwatthama, who can only release the Brahmastra, who can't recall or contain the effect. Like this, too many people know too many astras, too many weapons, knowledge of weapons, and too much of weapons got piled up, and any one guy going crazy, crank, suicidal, or getting into that pandemic fatigue, which emboldens people in the suicidal trend. Come what may, what can be done? That's all, my life is gone. Anyhow, I'm going down the drain. Let me pull the world also along with me. When I am not let to live, why it should be alive? These all thought currents usually come if you think you have only one life. If you realize the truth, you are going to come back again and again. You will leave this planet Earth safe, happy, rich, more powerful than when you entered, because you are going to come back. You will want the earth to be a better place when you come back again. But too many people become selfish and narrow-minded. I tell you, narrow-minded people start believing in one life. Large, broad visionaries realize the truth of multiple lives. That's why I tell you, believing in one life is superstitious. Many people, even though they know the truth of multiple life, sometimes they become narrow-minded due to delusion and start behaving like one life belief mental setup. One life superstitious mental setup. If you know, if you have the vision of the larger life, you will never do silly, stupid, suicidal, pandemic, arrogant, chemistry-based decisions. Too much of weapons piled up. Krishna has no other way. He has to destroy all the weapons in controlled condition. So he nicely collected all of them in one place, Gurukshetra, and finished off all the weapons and all the people who can't handle themselves but had the knowledge of weapons of destroying the whole Srishti. Those people and those weapons, everything he finished it off in controlled condition. That is why I say Krishna leading the Mahabharata war, personally sitting there for 18 days. Actually, Krishna was in quarantine at that time. Means he was just there, burning everything, healing everything, releasing everything, cleaning up everything without touching any weapon. He was there only as a catalyst for this whole cleansing to happen. He himself personally managing and making all the burning and cleaning all the weapons. I tell you, that is the greatest ahimsa, non-violence. Krishna is demonstrating his responsibility to protect the srishti. His responsibility as Parandama Vishnu, maintaining the world. He demonstrated in Krishna Avatara by conducting the Mahabharata personally and eliminating all the destructive energy and taking all the blame on himself for the war. Stupid are those who blame Krishna for Mahabharata war. If Mahabharata war has not happened, even if it was one day delay, some fool would have destroyed the whole planet Earth. The Srishti would have been lost. Srishti would have been lost. How in all this, in the teleserials, Devon ki Devi everywhere, they say, Srishti nashto ho jayega. That's the one word I memorized in all this. Devon ki Devi, all these TV serials. Srishti nashto ho jayega. In every serial this will come. Only then Mahadeva will wake up and say, come on. Now it is time. I have to go to the planet Earth and protect. Srishti nashto jayegi. Usually Narada will only go there. And Srishti nashto jayegi. Then Mahadeva will open his eyes and say, all I'll interview. From Kailasa he will do what he needs to do. Understand, that is cosmic level non-violence, responsible non-violence. Fools are those who blame Krishna for Mahabharata war. Fools are those who even think Mahabharata war was violence, who do not know the larger picture of life, call Mahabharata war as violence. Fools are those who accuse Krishna for Rasalila. Fools are those who abuse Krishna for Mahabharata war. Neither they know lust nor they know violence. Through Mahabharata war, Krishna demonstrated absolute ahimsa. Through the Rasalila, Krishna demonstrated absolute brahmacharya. Through all the strategies, Ashwatthama Atakunchanaha, to everything, Krishna demonstrated absolute satya. Having the best things of the world around him, Krishna demonstrated absolute aparigraha. Taking away not only things, even girls, whether butter or better off, taking away everything from so many people, he demonstrated absolute asteya, non-stealing. I tell you, he is peak of absolute purity, which can never be grasped by middle class mentality. He is an incarnation of purity, can never be grasped by middle class mentality. He stole the butter from so many houses. Nobody complained. Actually, they go to Nanda's house not to complain. In the name of complaining, to catch the one more glimpse of Krishna. That's all. When Krishna goes again back to their home for stealing, they catch him not to punish him, but to hold him and have him some more time in their home. By running away from the war with Jarasandha, Ranchod, he demonstrated brilliant courage. Understand? Viveka based courage. If he has not run away, escaped from Jarasandha, it would have been a pandemic fatigue, emboldened suicidal arrogance. If he has continued to fight with Jarasandha, that would have been like a pandemic fatigue, emboldening suicidal arrogance. That is not courage. He knows who can kill Jarasandha, who has to kill Jarasandha, and with Viveka, he strategizes. People who accuse Krishna because he ran away from war with Jarasandha are fools. People accusing Krishna for his Rasa Leela are fools. I have always seen people who accuse Krishna of womanizing due to his Rasa Leela. Soon their stories of all their perversion comes out. புரிஞ்சவன் பிஸ்தா புரிஞ்சுக்கோ. கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் அப்சல்யூட் பிரம்மச்சாரி. ஆல் தோஸ் ஹூ அக்யூஸ் தேர் ஸ்டோரிஸ் வில் கம் அவுட் சூன் அண்ட் கமிங் அவுட் சூன். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? பீப்புள் ஹூ பிளேம் கிருஷ்ணா ஃபார் மகாபாரதா are fools. People who accuse Krishna for killing Shishubala for just verbally insulting Krishna. Hey, Shishubala was not just verbally insulting Krishna. He was destroying many people's Krishna bhakti, through which they will all be enlightened and liberated. See, each disciple is literally Jnana Garbha. I am holding. When your Guru Bhakti feeling connection is destroyed, it is equivalent to one abortion. Shishubala was doing too many abortions, spiritual abortions. That is when Krishna has no other way. So the cosmic non-violence, cosmic ahimsa need to do its job. Understand? this pralaya, pandemic. Is a great cosmic ahimsa manifestation. Blessed are those who stand with Krishna. Svalpamapyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. Even practicing little bit of dharma during this pandemic, this pralaya, will do great good to you. Practice more and more and more non-violence and clutching. Feeling connection. Japa, japa of Mahavakya. Oneness, I tell you, actually all these six which I am saying, unclutching, completion, oneness, ajapa, japa of Mahavakya, deep feeling connection, all these, start practicing all these whenever you like, whatever, one. All these lead to same space. But you will not be able to practice only one and achieve the highest. Because after some time, the mind suddenly seems to be not settling down just with unclutching. Then you may need to do little completion. At some time, neither unclutching nor completion will seems to be settling you into samadhi. So practice oneness and watch oneness capsule. At some time nothing will work, then do ajapa japa. Sometime all this will start working, do whatever works. All these are one and the same. If you do completion, you will fall in nirvikalpa samadhi. If you are in oneness with Swamiji, you will fall in nirvikalpa samadhi. If you are unclutching, you will fall in nirvikalpa samadhi. If you are doing power manifestation, you will fall in nirvikalpa samadhi. If you are chanting the Mahavagya intensely inside, you will fall in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Everything is one and the same. Sometimes you enjoy coffee, sometimes you enjoy hot chocolate, sometimes you enjoy tea. Like this, it's a different variety. You can enjoy anything. All these six lead to the same space. Enjoy. By personally guiding and managing the Mahabharata war, Krishna demonstrated the absolute extreme commitment to the Srishti, creation, and demonstrated his cosmic non-violence. A doctor removing the tumor with the knife is not violence. That is the absolute non-violence for your life. He did the best to your life. Same way, Krishna conducting the Mahabharata war personally is the greatest demonstration of non-violence and love cosmically. I tell you, Krishna manifested 100 times more love during the Mahabharata war than when he did Rasalila. His intense love energy and compassion, aura, was responsible for destroying all the weapons and negative knowledge in the controlled condition, protecting the whole Srishti. Just in his breathing space in Gurukshetra, he created a chamber in which all these Brahmastras and the knowledge of various other destructive weapons can be burnt away. Mahabharata war is the ultimate demonstration of Krishna's cosmic non-violence. Rasa Leela is the ultimate demonstration of Krishna's cosmic brahmacharya. Aswatthama atakunjanaha. If you read Mahabharata, he made Dharmaraja utter so-called lie, which is not lie actually. Even factually it is not lie. And this whole trick, through that he demonstrated his cosmic satya, his commitment to the satya of the cosmos. By running away from Jarasandha's war with Jarasandha, he demonstrated absolute life positive courage. Hey, going and committing suicide, is it courage? Stupid. That is called pandemic fatigue. Life itself is a pandemic. When you feel fatigue with this life pandemic, you get emboldened. That's called suicidal arrogance. Like how these kids go for the COVID party to see who gets infected. Attending COVID party is the courage? Stupid. It is suicidal arrogance. Leaving the guru, attending COVID party, all these are suicidal arrogance, not courage. It's not courage, it is suicidal arrogance. Is guru abusing gang? COVID-19 parties are one and the same. Attending COVID-19 parties and going and talking to guru abusers and guru drohis is one and the same. Both are suicidal arrogance, not courage. That is why I insist on, don't talk to guru drohis, guru abusers, because it is like a virus. They can put it inside you without your knowledge, without your ability to control you, safeguard you. Krishna demonstrated visionary courage by withdrawing from battle with Jarasandha, Ranchod. That is why the word Ranchod should not be used as a defaming way to Krishna. It should be used as such beautiful glory of his visionary courage demonstration. So many times I tell you, person who is standing in the road can see 10 vehicles coming from this side, 10 vehicles coming from this side. He can see only 100 feet, 100 feet. But person who is standing on the top of the 25th floor and seeing, he can see this side 10 kilometer, this side 10 kilometer. He can see this side 1,000 vehicle, this side 1,000 vehicle. Hey, I can see the past and future larger than you because I am unclutched. So based on that, I make decisions. Let this pralaya manifest and settle down, then you will understand every word I did, every word I uttered, every action I did was to prepare myself and all of you to successfully sail through this pralaya and give superconscious breakthrough to the post-pralaya world. Understand. By stealing butter from Gopikas, even as a kid, so many stories, descriptions about Krishna stealing is there, including women. With all the stealing, he demonstrated cosmic aste. People who claim or accuse Krishna as a thief, chore, or fools. You can never understand the cosmic scale. Actions and reactions, manifestations of Krishna. listen to Krishna, enjoy Krishna, celebrate Krishna, worship Krishna. Don't try to measure him with your stupid, perverted incompletions. People accuse Krishna of stealing 16,000 women from Narakasura, but those women worship Krishna for saving them, rescuing them from Narakasura and giving them the status of his own wives. The 16,000 women did not have sexual relationship with Krishna, or Krishna did not marry them for sexual pleasure. He wants to give them the status of his own patnis, ardanginis. It's a greatest tyaga Krishna has done. I tell you, because he rescued them from Narakasura. No men want to marry those women. They may be thinking, they are all thinking that, oh, these women are Narakasura keeps, and why should we marry them? So those women did not have any life, hope, future. He said, don't worry. He declared all of them as his own wives and gave them that status. What more do you need than to be called as Krishna Patni? What a sacrifice, knowing that whole world will accuse him, abuse him. He doesn't care. He cares only about the people who came to him, who surrendered to him. Those women prayed to Krishna to be rescued from Narakasura. And he rescued them, not only rescued them, gave them the status in life, everything needed for life. What a personality. Abad Bandhava Anada Rakshaka. Absolutely only Krishna fits for that word. What a tyaga. He knows forever in the history he is going to carry that accusation, abusal, bad name as womanizer, but doesn't bother. This, protecting them and giving them the status is more important for me than any accusation. What a personality, not to be bothered about how he is going to go down in the history. Sacrificing your food, wealth, clothes, even sex, and becoming sannyasi. All that is too small tyaga. Then this tyaga, personality like Krishna, how he is going to go down in the history is such an important thing, but he is ready to sacrifice even that. Pranamami muhurmuhu. Krishnam vande jagadguru. Pranamami muhurmuhu. I bow down again and again and again. Krishna's tyaga. I can be absolutely sure not one of those 16,000 was used for the purpose of sex or pleasure by Krishna. I am 120% sure. He just rescued the sex slaves of Narakasura and gave them the status of Krishna Patnis. Absolute compassion. Never he used any one of them for sexual or any other pleasure. Why he needs pleasure? Such extraordinary sacrifice, including the sacrifice of how he is going to be go down in the history. That is why I say you need Divya Chakshu to see Krishna. That's why he says, Divyam Dadamide Chakshu. I give you the Divya Chakshu to see my larger picture, larger me. Only you can see larger me can understand why I withdrew from humanity. Why I self-quarantined myself. Pralaya is not yet over. It only started. It is not even fully triggered. Fully it will be triggered by December 14th. Then after that, the cascading crisis. Chemistry of this pralaya deluge will instigate extreme negativity and suicidal arrogance. The only way to save yourself from this, don't sleep more than 6 hours. Keep yourself in higher and higher consciousness by whole day. Either practicing unclutching, completion, working with Kailasa Digital Nation. See, when you work with Kailasa Digital Nation, you constantly inhale me. You are in my breathing space. Listen, whoever is working for Kailasa Nation building, You are in my breathing space during the time you are working for Kailasa building. Directly, indirectly, any way you are building Kailasa digital nation, e-nation. You are in my breathing space. By building Kailasa, by unclutching, by completion, by ajapa ajapa, by oneness, by feeling connect, keep yourself intensely active and in higher zone. Action is the ultimate alchemy. Action is the ultimate alchemy. Consciously deciding to be in oneness with Paramashiva beyond known and unknown confusions and incompletions. Tell Paramashiva, beyond my known unknown completions, incompletions, I surrender to you, O Paramashiva, keep me in oneness with you. Let me be in oneness with you, whether I know it or not, whether I am complete about it or not, let me be in oneness with you, because I know you exist. I may not have seen you, but my Guru has seen you. You are introduced to me by someone whom I trust, my Guru. My Guru has told you exist, so I know you exist, even if I have not personally experienced. So I know you exist, and you are the source of my existence. So please keep me in oneness with you. As you gave it to my Guru, give it to me. Desire to be integrated beyond your delusion, that is integrity, oneness, unclutching, completion. Understand? Something which doesn't challenge you, doesn't change you. Same way, integrated something which you are seeing every day is not great transformation. Integrated to something beyond your personal experience, but that reality raises you to that reality. I call that as cosmic integrity. So, essence of today's satsang. Through the alchemy of unclutching, break the chemistry of pralaya, deluge, eco-pandemic. He'll explain the biology of this pralaya in further satsang. So with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Shaivam. The state, space, powers, being, super consciousness, and Kailasa Paramashiva. Paramashivoham. ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम द एटर्नल ब्लिस नित्यानंद थैंक यू बी ब्लिसफुल
ॐ विष्णो रणाटमसि विष्णो पृष्ठमसि विष्णो स्नेत्रे स्रो विष्णो स्यूरसि विष्णो ध्रुमसि ज्येष्ठमसि विष्णवे त्वा
नित्यानन्द गोपाल हे नन्दलाला
नित्यानन्द गोपाल
नित्यानन्द गोपाल हे नन्दलाला
नित्यानन्द गोपाल
राधे गोपाला गोपी गोपाला
राधे गोपाला गोपी गोपाला
राधे गोपाला गोपी गोपाला
राधे गोपाला गोपी गोपाला
नित्यानंद गोपाल हे नंदलाला
नित्यानंद गोपाल हे नंदलाला
राधे गोपाला गोपी गोपाला
राधे गोपाला
मीरा के नाद प्रभु मुरली गोपाला
मीरा